WLKY weather with Chief Meteorologist Jay Cardosi.
Well, from an Arctic chill early last week to the ice late last week to the severe storms of last night and this morning to the rain now, and now we're looking at another Arctic chill moving on in, only in the Ohio Valley, right? Wow, what a period of weather we've had. These ups and downs. Here's a time-lapse review of today's weather from the Ollie Center looking westbound. Certainly mostly cloudy skies after the morning rain, and then the next batch of rain is pushing across the region as we speak. And the batch of rain that's over us right now, folks, that is the cold front. Temperatures will start to really drop off and the winds will pick up as we head on into and through the evening. Let's go right to the radar scope right now. You can see this band of heavier rain extending from Goshen through Prospect down into, let's say, the St. Matthews area, and then off to the south into Bullitt County. That marks the cold front, and it's actually extending all the way from Jefferson County, Indiana, back to just west of E-Town. Still some showers left over behind it. So as the temperatures fall, we're still going to be dealing with some scattered showers the next few hours. But one thing's for sure, it is going to be getting cold in a hurry, especially the next 2, 3, 4 hours. And then we're watching an Arctic plunge that's going to be building in here starting tomorrow night. So yeah, more big changes in store. Right now, wow, it's mild at the 5 o'clock hour. We're talking about middle and upper 50s in town. Humidity is 67%. A south to southwest breeze at 15, but those winds are changing directions as we speak. And once they kick in from the west northwest, look what's building in here. We have the 50s right now, but boy, 38 already in Indy. And look at this, below freezing or at freezing from St. Louis up to the Quad Cities. That air is going to plunge in here later on tonight through tomorrow morning as well. Back in time we go. There are the showers and storms of earlier today. Not a lot of lightning with those things late last night, earlier this morning, but certainly lots of wind energy. Now the severe threat is ongoing across the southeastern United States. A little bit farther off to the north of us, they've been dealing with some heavy snow in the Hawkeye State up through Wisconsin. But you know what? This is the next system we're watching, because this is going to start diving off towards the southeast, more jet stream energy. But with colder air in place, we're talking about the chances for some snow. At this time, it looks to be very light snow now, not a big snowstorm on the way. Let's jump forward in time. This is our exclusive in-house forecast model. Notice we're at 1 o'clock early tomorrow morning. Cloudy skies, a few flurries will be possible, and I think we'll wake up to the chance for a couple of flurries tomorrow morning. It's going to be cold, though, and breezy with temperatures just in the middle and also the upper 20s. During the midday hours, we should see a break in any precipitation, mostly cloudy skies, and watch what happens. Later in the afternoon and tomorrow evening, as the Arctic front nears, another batch of light snow is expected to form and sweep across the WLKY viewing area. And yeah, there could be some light accumulations. I mean, generally speaking, a half inch or dusting is what we're expecting right now for most of us. But you can see the temperatures just dropping like a rock. Once this front moves through, it looks like by Friday morning, we could see upper single digits and lower teens for temperatures. Wind chills will be well below zero Friday morning. Ugh, here are the details now. Next few hours, rain early, then windy, colder. The 50s we have will plunge into the 30s. By 10 o'clock tonight, 39 degrees, blustery and cold. Could wake up to a few flurries tomorrow morning at 26. Midday temperatures 33, mostly cloudy skies. And then here comes that next chance for a little bit of light snow later tomorrow and tomorrow evening. And it is going to get cold behind that front. 12 Friday morning, 23 the high Friday afternoon. And then we'll come out of it. Another chance for a few snow showers on Saturday. Super Bowl Sunday still looks to be the pick of the weekend with a little bit of sun around and temps right around 40. So no problems getting to your Super Bowl party.
Yeah.
That's good. So this cold spell is going to be quick. Anyway.
It is. About a day and a half, and it should be moving out.
All right. Thanks, Jay.